In this video, I'm going to show you how to apply lipstick and makeup to your images. So let's start. So I'm going to go to my actions and then I'm going to select the lipstick action here. I'm just going to click on it. So the action is here. So what I'm going to do from here, I'm just going to select my model's lips. Let me just zoom in like this. And then I'm going to go to my tools here. Then I'm going to select the pen tool here. Let me just zoom in a little bit. I'll make a point here. I'll make another point here. I'll make another point here, 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 and then I'll join it here. I'm going to go back to my pen tool here, and then I'm going to select the curvature pen tool here. Now I'm going to make the curves in my selection. I'm going to make a point and then push it up. I'll make another one here, another one here, another one here, another one here, like this, another one here. I'm going to right click and then I'm going to select make selection. On feather here, I'm going to put 0.5. Then I'm going to click OK. I have a selection of my model's lips. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to put this selection into this layer mask here. So I'm going to hold Control plus I on the keyboard like this. So this selection is now loaded in this layer mask. So I'm going to save this selection just in case I need it. I'm going to go to my tools here, then I'm going to select the rectangular marquee tool. I'm going to right click, then I'm going to select save selection here. I'll just name it as lipstick. And then I'm going to click OK. I'm just going to right click, and then I'm going to select deselect here. I'm going to open the lipstick folder, and then I'll just select this lipstick. Or if I want, I'm going to select this lipstick. If I want, I can select this lipstick. So let me just zoom in. The edges of our selection is too sharp. So what I'm going to do now, I'm just going to soften this selection. I'm going to go on the folder properties here. I'm just going to click on this icon. So if you can't find these properties here, just go to window and then select properties here. So I'm just going to feather this selection. I'll just move this. R4 is okay. I'm going to zoom out. Control plus zero on the keyboard like this. So this is our before, this is our after. So if I don't want to use this, I can use maybe this one or this one, or maybe this one, or maybe this one, or maybe this one, or maybe this one. So if you don't want to use these colors, you can just enable any color here and then double click here. Color picker is going to pop up. So you can change this lipstick to any color that you want from here. If you want, you can even pick the color from the background on the model here like this. I'm just going to click OK here. Let me just close this folder. So the next thing that I'm going to do, I'm just going to add the lip gloss to my model's lips. So I'm going to go to my actions here. So if you can't find this action button here, just go to window here, select actions here. The action panel is going to pop up. So I'm going to go to my actions here and then I'm going to select soft wet lips. I'm going to click on it like this. Okay, so instead of selecting my model's lips again, I can just go to my tools here and then select the rectangular marquee tool. And then I'm going to right click and then I'm going to select load selection here. And then I'm going to look for the lipstick selection here and then I'm going to click OK. So I can use this or I'm going to right click and deselect. So since this lipstick selection is already loaded into this layer mask, I'm just going to select this layer mask and then I'm going to alternate on the keyboard. I'm going to left click and drag this on this layer mask on top here like this. So Photoshop is going to ask me to replace this layer mask with this layer mask here. I'm just going to click on yes. So what I'm going to do now, I'm just going to paint out the lipstick from my model's teeth. So I'm going to go to my tools here and then I'm going to select the brush tool. I'm going to change my foreground color here to black like that. I'll just zoom in like this. So on this layer mask, I'm just going to paint out the part where I don't want this effect to be applied to. Like that. I'm going to go back to my adjustments here and then I'm going to select the lipstick color layer mask here. And then I'm going to paint out the lipstick here. Let me just zoom out. Control plus zero on the keyboard. So this is our before, this is our after. So I'm going to reduce the opacity of this four down top. I'll reduce it to maybe 30%. So this is the before, this is our after. This is the before these two adjustments, and this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. Let me show you how you can use these makeup actions here. So I'm going to click on the eyebrows darken here. So the two is already selected for me. I'm just going to zoom in like this. I'm just going to paint on the eyebrows like this. Then I'll move this side. I'll paint the eyebrows like this. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. I'll make my brush a little bit smaller and then I'll paint like that. So from here, I'm going to select the eyelashes darken. I'm going to click on it. The two is already selected for me. I'm just going to paint on the eyelashes like that. I'll move this side and then I'll paint on the eyelashes like that. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. I'm going to go back to my actions and then I'm going to select the eyeshadow color picker. So the two is already selected for me. With this action, you have to pick the eyeshadow color that you want. I'm going to alternate. The icon will change to the color picker. And then I'm just going to pick any color from here. So I'm just going to left click to pick the color like that. So I'll just make the brush a little bit bigger and then I'll just paint here like that. I'll move this side and then I'll just paint like that. I'm going to zoom out, Control plus zero on the keyboard. If the effect is too much, you can just reduce the opacity of the eyeshadow here. I'm going to select the eyeshadow pop. I'm just going to click on it. The two is already selected for me. So I'll just paint on the eyeshadow like this. And then I'll reduce the opacity of the eyeshadow pop to maybe 35%. So from here, I'm going to go to my actions and then I'm going to select the smoky eyes. Let me just zoom in a little bit. And then I'll just paint the smoky eyes here. So it's dark this side. We are not going to paint anything here. So this is the before, this is the after. I'm going to reduce the opacity to maybe 40%. This is the before, this is the after. The next thing that I'm going to do, I'm going to go back to my actions here, and then I'm going to select the mascara pop. I'm just going to click on it. So the two is already selected for me. Let me just zoom in a bit, and then I'll make my brush a little bit smaller using the brackets on the keyboard. And then I'll just try to add the mascara here. Like this. Let's move here. So here it's a little bit dark. So I'm going to reduce the flow to maybe 50%. And then I'll just paint the mascara like that. Like that. So this is the before. This is our after. This is the before. This is our after. Let me just zoom out. Control plus zero on the keyboard. So this is the before. This is our after. This is the before, all the adjustments. This is our after. This is the before. This is our after. So if you want, we can even add some lousy cheeks. I'm just going to click on the lousy cheeks here. Make the brush a little bit bigger using the brackets on the keyboard. Then I can add this like that, even this side. And then I'm going to reduce the opacity to maybe 20%. So this is the before, this is the after. Let me just add one action. I'm going to go to my pro actions here, and then I'm going to click on the face pop here. So this is the before, this is the after. Let me just reduce the opacity to maybe 30%. This is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. So I want this effect to just be on the face. So I'm going to hold Control plus I on the keyboard to invert the layer mask. I'm just going to paint where I want this effect to be. I'll make my brush a little bit bigger and then I'll just paint. So I'm going to take my flow to 100%. Like that. So this is the before, this is our after, this is the before, this is our after. So these actions are in my Beauty Retouching Actions Pack. I'll put the links to where you can download my Beauty Retouching Actions Pack in the video description below.